Hello, hello, welcome. Welcome everyone. Welcome to our webinar. We are talking about, Jim, we got a lot to talk about today, right? I'm gonna give people a couple minutes to join. I see people coming in. We're talking about product release updates, all the stuff you've been working on. Jim, how are things up in up north today? How are things in Canada?
Not too bad. Well, it's a great Good Friday. A little bit overcast, a mix of weather, sun and cloud, just the way we like it up in Vancouver. Cool and then super hot in the summer.
That's great. And you got that West Coast weather too. So I'm the complete opposite here. I'm in New Jersey right now. I've got my Easter look going and I'm ready to go. So welcome everyone. Just a couple housekeeping things. You know, feel free to put any questions in the chat. We'll be seeing them and we'll be answering them. Some will pause and wait till the end, but some will be able to answer as we go. I'd be interested to see where everyone's calling in from. So feel free to type that in the chat. I'd love to get a good chat going. That's always fun. So Jim, what are we here? What are we talking about today? Let's just dive right in.
Yeah, for sure. So today we are going over the feature release that we released a couple of days ago for our Password Manager version 2. So we're super excited about it. We had a lot of feedback from all of our partners. For a number of months, the engineering team worked diligently for quite a while to make sure that we got everything implemented, et cetera. Definitely wanted to go over each of the new exciting features and also kind of wanted to talk about what this kind of leads us into and what these new features opens up about, you know, what's next, especially with their integrations, and also, you know, what other new features we're going to be releasing in the next quarter or so.
Yeah. No. Thank you, Jim. Well said. So just so everyone's clear, we're going to be going into a demo in a little bit, walking through all the new features. And then afterwards, we'll talk about a little bit what's next. But Jim, before that, you've been pretty busy, right? I mean, been growing out our engineering team. There's been significant growth among there. I mean, there's an aggressive product schedule. What have you been up to like these first 3 months of the year?
Yeah, well, the team at QuickPass has been working quite hard in increasing our headcount, increasing our engineering team, our marketing team as well, so that we can attend all the events, et cetera. Really trying to make sure that we get a team of rock stars in place so that we can really implement the vision of the product moving forward. As you know, a lot of people know, it's quite a competitive marketplace out there to hire good talent. We've got Microsoft and Amazon in Vancouver, and we've spread our wings so that we're hiring people in other cities, especially with the work from home stuff. And, you know, we're not done yet. And so this is just the beginning.
Yeah, it's really exciting. I mean, I've been with QuickPass for, I guess, 3 months today, just about. So it feels like 5 years in those 3 months, but it's really exciting to see the team grow out. And it's just, I mean, the amount of engineering talent that we've added is just really impressive. So I commend you for that. And, you know, as you'll see from the release today, they're up to a lot of work. So Jim, why don't we just get into it? I think the best way would be, you know, we sent out some bullets in our release notes of the key things that were in this release. It was on the webinar registration as well. So let's just walk through them, demo each thing. Then if anyone has questions, feel free to throw them in the chat. I might stop you along the way and ask you to explain something to me. A lot of these features I'm seeing, demoed, you know, I've studied a little bit, but not really demoed on this demo account live. So, you know, you might have some live commentary and some genuine reactions coming from me. So I'll hand it over to you, Jim, and let you run the show and open up a screen share.
For sure. I'll just share my screen here in one sec. All looking good there. You're able to see the screen?
Yes, definitely.
Okay, awesome. So as some of you might have known and certainly asked, you know, the first integration that we came up with was our IT Glue integration. And a lot of our customers are IT Glue customers, which is great. And a lot of our product is geared towards that integration. One of the things that we recognized a little over a year ago or so is that, you know, not everybody is with IT Glue or another documentation system. And some other people may not want to actually store their passwords in their documentation system. So we wanted to be able to open up our product, especially our rotation services and our self-serve, et cetera, for people that either didn't have IT Glue or another documentation system that stored their passwords, or wanted to keep them separate. So that was kind of one of the main reasons why we came out with this. Now, initially, as some of you might have already noted or known, you can only have either the IT Glue integration or Hoodoo integration or the QuickPass Password Manager. They're kind of mutually exclusive at this point. However, we are going to be opening it up in our next release to be able to have them on both at the same time and to be able to have a synchronization feature between the two of them. And this particular update really opens the door with that, to be able to have the features that we might not have had before, to be able to make that possible. So the first thing that I wanted to show here is I've got the passwords menu shown here. Before this update, the only password entries that could be in the system were ones that were linked to an account source. So as most of you know, we have integration with Active Directory, Microsoft 365, slash Azure AD, and local Windows accounts. And so the purpose of that was, you know, for our rotation services or whether or not you wanted to remember any password that was linked to one of those accounts, that you'd be able to have a password entry linked directly with that. But you weren't able to add in third-party password entries, like if you had a password to, you know, VMware or Dell ID Rack or something like that. So now with this update, you have the ability to do that. So for example, you can go in and add any password you like. You can, you know, obviously type in the standard fields such as display name, username, select from a predefined list of account types. Other, you can put a computer name, notes, password. You can put in a one-time password secret key, which is also another feature we've got here, as well as one of the really cool features that we've added here is our new generate password feature. Now, before this, with our password rotation, we had the ability to use both passphrases and a sort of a regular complex password. But we didn't have the ability to create a complex password that was very long, like 99 characters, for example. And so now you can actually create a password if you'd like, all the way up to 99 characters, or use one of our passphrases options, not only just in a third-party password entry, but also for our password rotations and our regular reset password function. So for example, if I wanted to just have something completely insane, 99 characters, and you know, obviously nobody's ever gonna be able to type that out and figure it out, I'll use the regular complex password functionality. However, if I wanted to use something that was a little bit more palatable from being able to read, but yet still secure, that's where you can use one of the passphrase options where we give you either the 4 or the 5 word options. And if somebody hasn't really heard the reasoning in terms of passphrases, the explanation for it is, in particular, if somebody has to actually look at a password and type it, having a passphrase makes it a lot easier to do that if you're doing that at a console. The other thing is that the main part about password security, it's not about complexity. It's about length. So these passphrases are typically between 30 and 40 characters long, even though there's concerns of dictionary attacks if you're using a one word, for example, word in a password, but that's not necessarily the case with a sort of larger 4 to 5 word passphrase, as well as it includes, still satisfies complexity in most cases with an uppercase letter at the beginning, and then dashes between the words. So it kind of gives you a mix of both worlds of, you know, being long enough so that it's still quite secure, but also easy to type and use. But again, everybody has their own preferences. That's why we wanted to keep it flexible and give people either option. So obviously once you pick the password and hit fill, the option's there. You have the option as well to, as you know, with most of one-time passwords, when you set up MFA in a certain system, You'll end up getting a secret key in addition to a QR code. You can just paste it there and then hit save, and then you'll get the rotating code once it's created. The other thing that we wanted to mention, which is another feature that we've got here that we didn't have before, is the ability to restrict by security group to a particular password entry. So you can do this with any password entry in our system, whether it's a third-party password entry or with a password entry that's linked to an account, for example, from Active Directory, et cetera. And all you would do is hit restrict by security group, hit add, and then it gives you the ability to restrict from one of the groups you would have created from login management. And then you can just select that. And when you're done, you can just hit save and you're good to go. One of the things to kind of note here as well, as I mentioned, there's two different types of password entries, right? There's the ones that are linked with an account or a directory source, like Active Directory, et cetera, and there's the third party one. So you'll notice that in our little list here, we've got this QuickPass linked password column. So the ones with the green dot means that that password entry is linked to a directory source, right? And the ones where that is gray basically means that it's a third party password entry. And part of the differences between those is that you can't actually, or we do this intentionally, we don't allow you to delete the password entries that are linked to a QuickPass account because we want to keep those intact until you delete the actual account in QuickPass. So for example, if I went in and to this end user account menu and selected this particular user and deleted them from here, what it would do is it actually keeps the password entry, but it converts it to a third-party password entry. So you can delete the account that might be used for self-serve or password rotation, but a lot of partners expressed the need to actually retain the password because maybe they're trying to fix something, they might still want to retain the password, and they don't want to delete the password entry, but they want to delete the account in the system so that the end user left the company, they can't use the self-serve system, et cetera, right? So that's just something that we do to protect people. But with a third-party password entry, once it's in that state, then you're more than able to delete that if you need to at a different time. The other part here that we added is the actions menu on the password screen. So, in other systems and other password managers, you might want to just quickly go in and copy the username, copy the password, copy the one-time password. And so we've added that ability in our passwords menu under the actions menu. And so you can either copy the username to the clipboard, copy the password, or reveal the one-time passcode, and then you can obviously copy that off the screen as well, and it just copies the clipboard, etc. So that's definitely a nice, easy to use feature. The other thing that a lot of our partners expressed interest with was the ability to share passwords with, on a temporary basis with contractors, for example. So let's say you have a temporary contractor working as an IT administrator or system admin, and they needed to get access to credentials to a certain system, but you only wanted to securely share that with them for a very short period of time, or only once, and then after they've looked at it or viewed it, to be able to kill the access to it. So that's what we've done here with this option here to share the password. And so the options that we have here is you can either do expires in a specific time limit, such as 30 minutes, 60 minutes, et cetera, up to a week. You can add a message in there, and you can choose to include the username, the one-time passcode. And obviously, if you don't check those, then only the password is shown and not the other credentials. But the most interesting part about here is that they expire after the first view. So for example, if I include that and I share it out and I go to that URL, after the person ends up looking at the credentials for the first time, and if they either close the tab, the browser, or refresh the page, the link is no longer available. So if I go ahead and do this over here, I copy this link. I'm going to put this into my other browser here. So then they effectively get a page like so, where they can either copy the username, they can copy the password, they can reveal the password, they can also reveal the OTP and copy the OTP, etc. But once I refresh the page here, the link is no longer available. Jimmy, I think I heard you say wow, but you're muted, so.
I said, wow, yeah, it's so useful. And like, I'm thinking too, because it'll be rotated if you have the rotation on the next day too. So, you know, contractor needs to go in, you know, change one account. They get access for literally that day only, and then the password's changed and they won't see the updated ones. It's good. I also keep hearing you say, a lot of people ask for this. A lot of people ask for this. A lot of people ask for this. So I just want to take a minute to plug our feedback session. Where, you know, Canny, I believe it is. So maybe you could just mention that as well, Jim, because a lot of this has come from there as well.
Yeah. So if some of you haven't already seen this, in our dashboard in the bottom left-hand corner, there's a feature request option here. And we use a platform called Canny.io. And what that allows you to do is if you click that, once you're in the dashboard, it will automatically take you to our feature request site, and you have the ability to either look at all the other feature requests that are made. You can comment on them, you can up and down vote on them, as well as you can add your own. And obviously we're looking at that on a daily basis, and it's a big driver for any of the new features that we're working on, and also to validate that we're on the right track with you know, the current product roadmap that we've got.
Yes. Thank you, Jim. We also, we had some questions come in as well. Can you just, you know, I don't want to reveal, you know, what's coming up. We can talk about that a little later, but maybe just talk about how the use of this password manager versus, like, somebody's question was, will the OTP sync into IT Glue and Hoodoo? So right now, if you're using IT and Hoodoo, just so we're clear, Jim, that you wouldn't be using this password manager, is that?
At the moment, yes. However, our very next development task on this, which we're really excited to start on, is the ability to have both this password manager and IT Glue and Hoodoo on at the same time so that we can sync them. Now, to answer the question about the OTP, on that particular thing, we're a little dependent on what's available in the API for each integration. So I can kind of speak to both IT Glue and Hoodoo. So at the moment, with respect to IT Glue, they don't actually reveal the secret keys for OTPs in their API. So what that means is that we can sync the passwords, but we're not actually able to get those OTP secret keys to be able to put them on our end. However, you would be able to, if you have the secret keys, either at the time of creation or later, add them in on our end and obviously have them both available at any time. When we talk about Hoodoo, on the other hand, they do actually have that available in the API for vendors to integrate with. So that is something that we will be able to do, not only sync the password, but also the secret keys. So hopefully that answers the question there.
We'll get into some more questions a little bit later. Let's go. Why don't you keep going down through the different features?
Yeah, for sure. So the other thing that I wanted to kind of mention here is we did actually make some changes also for people that don't even have the password manager access. Number one, for consistency, but also to kind of give people access to things that they were asking for as well. So for example, if I'm in the administrator accounts menu that I would do all the password rotations, et cetera, under the auto rotate settings, we also have added the ability to do a complex password up to 99 characters, which was something that was under demand quite a bit, in addition to the passphrases option, which we already did have. Whereas before, the ability to use a complex password, the length was much shorter. So definitely people are going to be kind of excited about that, to be able to do whatever preferences they want. All you have to do is, drag the slider over and hit save, and you're all good to go. And that'll obviously update in IT Glue or Hoodoo whenever you rotate the password next. The other thing as well, which is available to everybody, is the reset password modal. So regardless of what menu you're in, if you're trying to manually reset on a one-time basis, any administrator account, service account, or end user account, you also have access to the generate password option by clicking this little button here, and it opens up the same type of modal. So you can go in and you can give, you can use the passwords as there, which is something we didn't have in this menu, as well as, again, you can use the complex passwords up to about 99 characters. And then you can just hit reset or copy that. And if you had to, obviously, you know, get it somewhere else, you can do that as well. But where this is kind of neat is in particularly with the end users, because a lot of times when an end user calls a help desk and you're resetting a password for them, if you needed to, and you're giving them some, you know, random password that's really difficult for them to remember or whichever, you can then now use the passphrase option there, right? As I mentioned before, you know, it's something that is still secure because of the length, but because it's actual words, they can easily read it. So even if a tech had to, you know, take a call, say, okay, I'm going to reset your password, I'm going to give you this passphrase, and I can actually read out these words to you, you're probably have a much higher chance that the end user is actually going to be like, okay, that's, you know, I got it, type it in and they're good to go, versus, you know, trying to, you know, tell them some random complex password that might even be 10 characters. You're probably on the phone for 5 minutes going, no, I meant, you know, an exclamation mark and a question mark, and now at a capital A, no, I meant a lowercase a, right? So everybody knows about those conversations. They can take forever and be really frustrating for everybody. And so especially for end users, passphrases is a pretty cool thing. And to kind of top this all off, for our ConnectWise Manage integration customers as well, we've extended that feature within the ConnectWise Manage integration, which will also be something that will be made available once we release our Dato Autotask integration as well. So for example, in the pod here as well, for anybody who's using our ConnectWise Manage integration, that shows up in the little pod in the reset password module, rather than just having the ability to type in a password, again, you also have the generate password here as well. And, you know, the reasoning for having the pod is self-explanatory. Most techs, especially help desk people, will spend their time in the PSA and the ticket, and being able to, you know, reset passwords, unlock accounts, check the account status, do an identity verification request, which you were already able to do directly in the service ticket, is a lot more valuable than having to, you know, go into another system and, you know, then come back to the ticket and let the person know. So that is definitely something that that I wanted to share there. Moving on to another thing, unless there was some questions about the last couple of things that I mentioned there.
There was a question about the ability to sync, like time frame on that. So maybe I know that's sort of the thing that everyone wants to know, like when can I back up my IT Glue passwords in QuickPass? So I don't know if you want to cover that now or if you want to maybe save that for the end. I'll leave that up to you, Jim.
Yeah, no worries. Well, I can speak to that. So we're effectively starting on the development for it now. And as I mentioned before, this particular update was what we had to do first in order to make that possible. So that's why it's quite key. So this is good. That's going to be our next major feature that we're going to release outside of something that's already ready to go, and which I'll kind of speak to later. Mainly because of the demand, you know, having access to credentials for pretty important systems is, you know, obviously very important to our partners, and I totally get it. I was an MSP as well. So if there's any type of situation where you don't have access to those and you have your customers calling for support, it obviously puts you in a very difficult position. And as well as, you still might have the ability to export these things to CSV files or spreadsheets or whichever, but doing that is probably not a great security practice if you're going to leave that in your downloads folder. And if you happen to be a contractor for some big identity provider, I'm not naming any names, you might get into a little bit of trouble. So having the sync feature obviously is going to be a big deal for us. And this is going to be a Q2 release for sure for us. So
that's great. Jim, another question just came in about the third-party access. So I think the question is, like if you're sharing with third-party, so say I share it on a Monday, and they don't access it to a Wednesday and the password's rotated multiple times in between, will it share the updated password? And then after they access it, will it automatically rotate it, or does it just follow the normal rotation schedule? And then if they, maybe another use case or edge case, if they access it, say they have 30 days access and the password's rotated 30 times through those 30 days, how does viewing that password work?
Yeah, so the design of it is that it's supposed to show whatever the password is at the time that they look at it. So that kind of, so regardless of if it's rotated in between the time they share it versus it's shown, it's just going to show whatever the current password is. So that kind of satisfies that. In terms of when the rotation occurs, if they've accessed it or not, the rotations still do occur according to the rotation schedule. Although we do acknowledge that we've had a number of people ask for the ability to not only do that, but do it after passwords are accessed. And it's kind of a, you know, some people are obviously really like that idea in favor of not rotating unless somebody accesses. But what we are looking into is to do both when somebody accesses it as well as under a certain rotation schedule. Because one thing that is, there's a couple of different schools of thought, right? One is, you can either take the proactive stance, which is let's just rotate it, on a daily basis, for example, whether or not somebody's accessed it or not. And then the other school of thought is that, well, let's wait until somebody's accessed it, or maybe wait until the password's been breached until we rotate it. And I mean, our kind of thinking originally was it probably better from the proactive standpoint, because, if you're waiting to rotate something until it's either been breached or somebody's accessed it, sometimes that's too late and, sort of the cat's out of the bag, so to speak. So we certainly favor that, but we also recognize that people want to do that. So either what we're going to do is in the future is provide the option to say when you're sharing a password to allow it to be rotated once it's viewed, in addition to doing the rotation, or to just do that automatically as a by default, for example. So was that all the questions, or was there one more? I forget.
Yeah, no, that was it. That I think that answered everything.
Okay, cool. So as I kind of mentioned before, another big piece of password managers in general, as well as ours now, is the ability to audit, who has accessed the password, so that they can figure out, hey, if something happened, I want to know who's actually looked at the password, who's copied it, all that kind of stuff. So we've added specific events to be able to audit and track not only who's accessed a password, who's shared a password, who's edited a password, including, the particular login of it, the date and time, the customer, et cetera, so that we can have that audit trail. And then you can download the report for that, for the events to be able to iron that out and then filter by the login field, for example, because a lot of people who might not change their passwords and a technician leaves, they want to be able to get, some sort of an audit to be able to see, if that technician has access to password to be able to know, do I need to actually rotate that one? The other part too is that within the password entries, one thing we added, but we had to put on a brief pause on it, just to resolve an issue that we were dealing with, it is there's an access activity table that will also appear within the password detail screen. And essentially it just feeds the already data that we have on the events in that access activity. And it just gives a snapshot of, you know, who are the last, you know, five or so people to access that particular password entry, just out of a convenience thing. So there's just a couple of things that they needed to fix on that, that we detected after the release, that we'll be able to get to in the next week or so. But that's definitely coming down the pipe, and it was mentioned in the blog article. So I wanted to kind of mention that so that people are aware of it. I'm just trying to look at my list here in terms of any of the other features here. Yeah, I'll talk a bit more about here about the security group stuff. So as some of you who have used the system know, we do have a role-based security in the system. We've got currently four different roles: super admin, login role. We have the manager role, an engineer, and a help desk role. And effectively, the super and the manager have access to most of the things in the system, including the passwords. However, when you do want to restrict access to passwords, et cetera, those apply for both the engineer and the help desk roles. And what we can do now is effectively, you can go under our login management window, you can go under configuration and group management, and you can create a list of groups, whatever you want to call them, and you can add anybody from the engineer, the help desk roles. So if I go into one of these, for example, I can, you know, add in the particular logins, check the boxes from, you know, the ones that I'd want to be a member of the group, give it a particular name, hit save. And then what I can do is I can then restrict a password entry by that login group. And so just to kind of explain the logic in how that is done, if I go into one of these guys over here, and I see that the engineer admin group two, that particular group will have access to it. And what that means is that any of the engineers or the help desk login roles that are not a member of that group will not be able to see that password entry. Whereas if you're a member of the super or the manager group or login roles, even if you're not there, you will be able to see it, because those are sort of meant to be obviously engineers who you're not worried about them accessing different passwords, but any of your regular techs would kind of fall under that scope, et cetera.
Your pod-based groups, pod-based help desks as well.
Exactly, yeah. So in general here, that looks to be kind of most of the stuff that I wanted to cover here. So maybe what we can do right now is answer some of the other questions that we had, and mm-hmm. kind of also cover off what's coming up next down the pipe.
Yeah. There was a question a little while ago that I can take. It said something like somebody messaged us privately and said, did you update the branding? And I just wanted to point it out, when Jim had showed the shared password, it was a co-branded. So that was like a sample MSP logo. So I just wanted to clarify that. Yeah, and you have it in the top left corner over there as well. And you know, you can do that. And when you share, the password will have that logo on it. Another password for you, Jim. Are we able to rotate one specific user groups now for all new accounts? Or are we able to rotate all accounts with one click?
You can't. So I think what you're talking about is rotate all accounts for mm-hmm. all customers in one click. Was that the question? You can still.
Yeah, it was two questions. One, rotate all of the passwords for one specific user, or maybe who one user access. All the passwords one user access, perhaps, was the question. And then the second question was rotate all accounts with one click.
So great questions. Still currently, you can rotate via the select all menu for a particular customer at once for all the accounts in there. We don't yet have that capability in terms of being able to rotate all the passwords that a certain tech has access, But that's definitely a pretty awesome feature request suggestion. So I would say that we're certainly going to mark that one down. That'd be actually pretty neat to include, for example. And the ability to do a complete rotation of all passwords at once, because I know that was the, sort of a long-standing feature request that we've had. And what we've been doing in the background is building our infrastructure and microservices in such a way that that can be what I was would say gracefully done without causing too many hiccups. Because if you're not careful about doing like hundreds or thousands of password rotations at the same time, it can get a little bit dangerous. But that is still something that is something we're going to do. But that other question was actually a great suggestion, and we're going to definitely mark that one down.
Yeah, we had another question about user groups. Can you like later modify which group has access to a certain account or a certain password?
Yeah, so you can go in there and you can edit the, you can either add additional groups or you can remove a group from the password detail screen. So, and as well, you can go into the groups and you can edit, you know, who is in the group. You can edit the name of the group as well. So that's all dynamic and out of the box right now.
Yeah, Jim, we had some other questions too, feature specific questions. And I think what would be helpful is if you could talk a little bit about why this release was important, at least the way we see it at QuickPass. And we hope that, you know, our customers and partners see it the same way in the sense that this is like a foundation for things. So could you maybe talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, for sure. So as I was kind of mentioning before, we've had a lot of requests to be able to sync passwords from iTglue and Hoodoo. And in order to do that, we needed to have the ability to support third-party passwords as well as support the other features that they had, like OTPs, et cetera, the ability to copy, all that kind of stuff. This now allows us to implement that and have them both on at the same time. That will be optional though, because there are partners where they just don't want, if they have their iTglue integration, they may not want to have their passwords visible by anybody within our system. So what we're going to have is a option within the settings menu to be able to activate that capability as well as do the sync. And so that'll be optional for most of the partners, but we'd obviously think that the majority of people would want to enable that. But for the ones that don't, we're not going to force that on anybody. The other thing as well to talk to is that, a lot of people don't necessarily think that having passwords in your documentation system as well is a great thing. And so obviously why this was very important for us is that in order for people to only have their passwords in the system, even if it's just for privileged accounts and shared admin accounts, and et cetera, that at least had, a baseline of features that a normal password manager would have, as well as some other additional things that we're doing before they could actually rely on it and use it, right? So that was also a really critical thing for us getting this update out.
Yeah, and Jim, for something that I've seen a lot too, that I think you mentioned earlier, is people wanted the security functionality of not necessarily needing to store their passwords in the same place as their documentation tools, and sort of like, just segregating things and having them siloed out in the event that, a documentation tool either down, the sync would help that, but a breach in that having the passwords in the same place. So I think that, I personally am excited about that and giving, users the better ability to get passwords out, because you could store things in a separate password manager, like a LastPass or a Keeper. Like, there's so many great password managers and we all use them, I'm sure. But the ability to like rotate and all of the other features that you're getting from this, we really only have that today in QuickPass and in the documentation tools as well. So that's one of the reasons I'm really excited about it.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that's kind of what makes our product unique is just the ability to do those automated functions with the credentials that are in the platform that you wouldn't be able to do with a traditional password manager that only stores passwords. So, I mean, there's a lot of great, you know, specific password managers out there that are great at just storing passwords and OTP codes, but if you want to rotate them, well, you still got to do it the manual way, right? And that can obviously be very time consuming for, you know, most MSPs and companies, and often it just doesn't get done, right?
Yes, exactly. Well, Jim, I think, you know, it's a holiday for many of us, many people, and people probably have some plans this weekend. So I think that we should try to wrap this webinar up. If anyone has any additional questions, please feel free to email us directly. So it's kind of funny. We're Jim and Jimmy. So we're Jim at getquickpass.com. Jimmy, getquickpass. I'm Jimmy and he's Jim. You can email one of us. I get
some of his emails, unfortunately.
People mix us up all the time. All right. So we will thank you. Thank you everyone for joining. You know, feel free to follow up with us for any additional questions, and have a great weekend, everyone.
Awesome. Have a great weekend, guys.